teacher, I'd urge you to pick up one of the many books available that deal with the different sorts of utopian community, because the experimentation on human nature that was undertaken in those communities was borrowed, it was abstracted and utilized by government agencies. The lure of utopia, presumably humane utopian interventions, like compulsion schooling, which is supposed, after all, to be for the good of children, aren't always the blessing they appear to be. For instance, the invention of the safety lamp saved thousands of coal miners from gruesome death, but it wasted many more lives than it ever rescued, because without that invention, the coal industry would have always remained a peripheral business that would scrape the surface and leave the rest of it alone. The safety lamp allowed the subterranean depths of the earth to be dug out in little narrow tunnels, and the miner to be relatively safer in those tunnels than he would have been, but if he hadn't have been able to see in those tunnels, he never would have gone into them in the first place. The lamp alone allowed the coal industry to grow rapidly, exposing miners to mortal danger from which there is no good protection. In the year 2000, after an era of safety lamps and other scientific progress, 6,000 miners were lost to cave-ins and explosions in Russia alone. That's twice the death toll of the World Trade Center disaster in New York. What Sir Humphrey Davy, the inventor, accomplished with his lamp was a great gift, but not to coal miners. It was a great gift to coal producers.